This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is present, and where He is holy. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is present, and where He is holy. These are holy hands. He's given us holy land. He works through these hands, and so these hands are holy. These are holy hands. He's given us holy hands. He works through these hands, and so these hands are holy. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is present, and where He is holy. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground.
These are holy men who became friends of God, glorious heralds of divine truth. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. And today is the feast of Saint Cyril and Methodius. So let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who enlightened the Slavic peoples through the brothers Saint Cyril and Methodius, grant that our hearts may grasp the words of your teaching and perfect us as a people of one accord in true faith and right confession. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly to the Jews. We had to proclaim the word of God to you first, but since you have rejected it, since you do not think yourselves worthy of eternal life, we must turn to the pagans. For this is what the Lord commanded us to do when he said, I have made you a light for the nations, so that my salvation may reach the ends of the earth. It made the pagans very happy to hear this, and they thanked the Lord for this message. All who were destined for eternal life became believers. Thus the word of the Lord spread through the whole countryside. The word of the Lord. The response is, go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news. O praise the Lord, all you nations, acclaim him, all you peoples. Strong is his love for us, he is faithful forever. The Lord has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees came up and started a discussion with Jesus. They demanded of him a sign from heaven to test him. And with a sigh that came straight from the heart, he said, why does this generation demand a sign? I tell you solemnly, no sign shall be given to this generation. And leaving them again and re-embarking, he went away to the opposite shore. The Gospel of the Lord. The example of St. Cyril and Methodius is set before us today as we take up our daily tasks, and so we pray. We pray for bishops everywhere that they may tend the flock and trust them with care, courage, and perseverance. Lord, hear us. For priests and religious who engage in the work of Christ in difficult and trying situations, that their courage may not fail them in their hours of trial. May Christ the Good Shepherd be their inspiration and joy. Lord, hear us. For those who have borne the burdens and toils of the years and who are now retired from active ministry, may God's peace dwell with them always. Lord, hear us. And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us. And we pray for all who have died. We pray for Father Seamus McGinley, recently deceased. His funeral is tomorrow. And Sheila Murphy, whose first anniversary is today. Also the anniversaries of Sarah Smith, Caroline Byrne, Peter Corrigan, Annie O'Neill, and Sarah Breen. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Lord our God, may the lives of your holy ones inspire us to greater endeavor in the service of your people. May our lives be abundant in good works through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look, O Lord, upon the offerings which we bring before your majesty in commemoration of St. Cyril and Methodius, and grant that these gifts may become the sign of a new humanity, reconciled to you in loving charity. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Cyril and Methodius, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by their words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to their prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Cyril and Methodius, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. And for the distribution of Holy Communion, as usual, I will begin by distributing to those on my right hand, middle aisle. The Minister of the Eucharist will start over here at the Stations of the Cross site. When he's finished there, he'll go over to the choir site. And when he's finished here, I will then distribute to those on the left hand, middle aisle. And for those tuning in at home, we pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present at the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, Father of all nations, who make us sharers in the one bread and the one spirit, and heirs of the eternal banquet, grant in your kindness on this feast day of St. Cyril and Methodius that the multitude of your children, persevering in the same faith, may be united in building up the kingdom of justice and peace. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and stay safe.